From the 2008 financial crisis, Brexit, COVID-19 pandemic, to now latest, the outbreak of the Russia-Ukraine war, the world has experienced several crises over the last 15 years, some of which have distorted world value chains, markets, and spiking global inflation.
So as a result of this, we are seeing global trade and investments having to adjust now to heightened uncertainty in the global financial markets, with the potential persistence of flight to quality, especially in the looming public debt crisis in several African countries.
How best do policymakers respond to all these crises, like the Russia-Ukraine war that sparked increasing food prices and general inflation on the global and local scenes?
But if inflation is a structural problem and not a cyclical problem, it's a matter of when, not if, when Western central banks will hike again in the next 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. If African governments by then have not renavigated the public finance management world or thinking around commercial versus concessional debt, improving public investment efficiency in infrastructure, increasing domestic savings, improving revenue mobilization, then you know what? There'll be a lot more Ghanas down the road, sadly.
There has got to be policy flexibility amidst frequent exogenous shocks. If you are not going to have flexibility in policy amidst all the shocks that are hitting us, you are not going to survive this tight. So this is exactly what we have been doing right from the time COVID-19 hit. We moved from a situation where we were injecting liquidity into the system in order to support the resustenance of growth following the reduced aggregate demand. And because of the Russia-Ukraine crisis that hit us in February 2022, we had to shift gears, that the liquidity that was injected was going to be a risk in terms of stoking inflation if we did not remove that liquidity very, very fast.
This was during the Stanbic Economic Forum held in Kampala today, with discussions revolving around the implications of the crisis on the business outlook. Story by Benan Ojambo for the news.